And thank you all for being here. I am incredibly personally grateful for the time with you all today. I hope you take away from today's talk an understanding of how we in Claris are thinking about the construction of a platform, the building of it, the hardening of it, and making sure that it is something solid and sustainable for you for years to come. I want you to understand how important it is that I, personally, but also all of Claris Engineering, are ongoing partners for you in your development journey. I hold myself personally responsible and accountable for delivering against the promises that we make to you over the next 3 days. When I'm finished, my goal is that you all feel like you want to know more, like you want to explore all the pieces that we share with you today, how they work together, why they were constructed, to understand the full value that you can realize from Claris. Today, we offer FileMaker Pro with both on-premise and cloud-hosted server offerings. You have all been using these tools for years, some of you decades. Most of you, though, are not using Connect in Studio, and we recognize we need to do a much better job explaining what they are, why we've built them, and how they can benefit you. Neither is capable on its own of solving complex problems. But they both make things that are difficult in FileMaker easy to develop and deploy. And those are the driving impetuses for us in their construction. They're both meant to be used in conjunction with FileMaker, not on their own. And if we don't explain well how to do that, we're doing you a disservice. If you have a FileMaker solution and want to publish content to the web, Studio is the place that can do that easily for you in our platform for both named users and anonymous content. If you want to push pages to mobile devices around the planet with different layouts, Studio makes that easy in ways that FileMaker doesn't with its fixed layouts. FileMaker is a fantastic tool, and it's fantastic especially for what we call internal apps, internally facing apps, desktop applications. But if you want to gather data from external people, many of whom you don't know, or share information stored in a FileMaker solution in dashboards, Studio is the place you should first turn. And we all know that you can do those things, you can accomplish those things in FileMaker. And most of us have done that. But we also all know that it's painstaking and slow. Studio is starting to provide the sort of web UI your customers expect from a modern platform. Similarly, many of you successfully use FileMaker for data integrations. Connect is better. It's easier. It has enhanced logging, debugging, and security infrastructure over what you can build in FileMaker. It's a layer now that sits underneath both FileMaker and Studio, facilitating seamless, structured, repeatable interactions with external services. Louis will be on stage in just a couple of minutes to demonstrate some of the amazing things that you can do with it. We want to get all of you to a place where you understand and are leveraging the entire platform that we offer. And it's only when we accomplish that, that we are in a position where when we want to add new functionality capabilities to the platform, we can do so in the place where it's best and in a way where you can all benefit. Critical then also to that effort is enabling pricing and packaging that lets you use the entire platform. We already offer free Connect capabilities to anyone with a FileMaker license that's active. We will offer the same for Studio, free Studio capabilities for anyone with a FileMaker license that's active. And as it's apparently obvious to everybody, with this packaging, we'll remove a huge impediment to all of you having all of our tools. I want to see all of these tools available in every single one of your toolkits going forward, so that when you are approaching a problem, you can use the best tool that we make available every single time. Next, I want to talk about how we within engineering ensure that what we build feels like a platform, looks like a platform, works like a platform, and as I said, stays hardened and robust for years into the future. 2 years ago, up on a virtual stage, I introduced some core guiding engineering principles to you. North Stars, I called them. 2 years later, they are still quite literally written on the wall of my office, and they are referenced every single day in engineering and design reviews. I want to talk a little bit about how they play out in practice, how they influence what we've built. So let's go through them. The first is no friction to success. We want to see new developers getting to success, building their first solution without impediments. The second is providing one identity everywhere, making sure that you are you anywhere that you go in our ecosystem. The third, data everywhere, making sure that data available in one part of the platform is available everywhere in the platform. And then there are two that seem a little bit in conflict with each other, but we think provide a really good balance as we look to the future. So the fourth is honoring all of your investment in the platform and in Claris. And the fifth is making sure that new technologies and capabilities that we design are unconstrained by decisions that we've made in the past. So let's see how they have played out over the last 24 months. For the first one, ensuring customer success without friction. Like I just said, we need pricing and packaging adjustments that ensure that you are functioning without constraints. So we'll provide Studio and Connect free tiers to anybody with an active FileMaker license. We are still committed to providing access to a free version of FileMaker as well. Your on-premise deployments will continue to be supported, and we will continue to make cloud hosting more unified and seamless for those of you who would benefit from that option. As we are thinking about and designing the newer portions of our platform, we're ensuring that you don't need to understand schema in order to get started. There is always a virtual representation or a visual representation of that database entity available to you in a spreadsheet-like form. It feels familiar, WYSIWYG, and we handle things like screen resolutions for you. We want you focusing on the development of your solution, not handling a multitude of minutiae as you push things out around the planet. When it comes to unified identity across the platform, we're working towards a single place to manage user identity, including for cloud. It works well with Apple Connect, managed Apple IDs, and services like Active Directory. Initially, we're assuming that all users on the platform are either already using FileMaker or are new users coming in through Apple School Manager. As we design capabilities like groups and permissions in Connect and Studio, we are ensuring compatibility with FileMaker and with those directory services used by Apple School Manager. And we're making sure that all Studio building blocks support those groups and permissions for construction of things like project management and other complex solutions. Data accessibility throughout the platform is probably the most complex challenge that we face in Claris Engineering, or the most complex challenge to get correct. It's important to us that all FileMaker data types are representable in Studio in a bidirectional fashion and leverageable in Connect. It's important that in new parts of the platform, all data sources are represented in a spreadsheet-like fashion, like I talked about, that people don't have to think about or understand schema to build something valuable. Within Studio, initial data types have been chosen to support Studio functioning as a publishing engine and as a data gathering tool for FileMaker. And any new Studio data types that we stand up don't break anything in FileMaker when synchronizing back and forth between the two. We will consistently work to ensure that all portions of the platform remain healthy, fast, secure, and invested in. For portions that may one day see a sunset, tools like CCC in cloud, we will make sure they stay healthy until there's a replacement ready and hardened. When possible, we will leverage FileMaker as a target for new tech investments. And when that's not possible, we will make sure that your existing solutions will be able to benefit from capabilities and functionality that we add elsewhere in the platform. This requires us to let every developer leverage the entire platform, but it lets us put tech where it's best. Finally, We are very aware and we will always remember that today, all data in a Claris solution is on the FileMaker side of the platform. And that's why things like FileMaker Connect integration are so important to us. And it's why the AI investments that you'll see talked about in just a few minutes are happening entirely on the FileMaker side of the house right now. When we think about newer things that we're building and want to make sure that they're not improperly constrained, we're choosing modern data types and structural representations for them, even when they don't support FileMaker. Picasso famously said, "Good artists copy, great artists steal." When you look at our new calc and scripting engines, they are very powerful and they feel very, very familiar. We have been shameless in lifting the best patterns from our contemporaries. I'm proud of it. We're working to leverage core technologies like Mongo to provide eventually consistent document stores and eventually the ability to provide the sort of CDN that some of your solutions need, supporting the entire planet. And we assume that every single solution built going forward requires AI at different portions of the stack as table stakes. By being successful adhering to these guiding principles as we build our future together with you, we will ensure that you and your customers get your solutions up and running without artificial impediments, that we provide you with a platform that recognizes you as you, that your investments in one part of the platform will be leverageable elsewhere in the platform, that Claris is going to be able to put code where it's most efficient, and you will be able to benefit from it. And that we can build out the platform knowing that we are adding value and capabilities to your already deployed solutions. And finally, that we are bringing a new generation of customers into the fold through Apple School Manager. It's an incredibly exciting time to be a Claris developer and, frankly, a Claris employee. So thus far, I've been talking to you about engineering principles and vision. I want to transition now to concretely how we are going to share what we're working on with all of you in a visible backlog. It's hosted on the community site here. All of you have access to it. Everything in it is scoped and well understood by Claris Engineering. It's either in progress today or it's prioritized in our backlog for delivery in the next 2 quarters. I highly encourage everyone to go look at it. There are about 100 items on it. I'm not going to go through all of it here during the keynote, but from a category perspective, you know, there are server enhancements, application lifecycle maintenance enhancements, security enhancements, scripting and calculation work, infrastructure work, AI and large language model support. There's a pile of really, really amazing things coming, and they will keep coming.